Hello everyone, today I'm in beautiful Munds Park, Arizona, and I'm going to give you a video tour of this wonderful place. Now just to give you a little bit of information about Munds Park, it is a small resort town about 15 minutes south of Flagstaff. It's really a resort town. There are some people that live here year-round, but most of the homes here are weekend cabins, summer cabins, ski cabins, and part-time living. Even though there's a population of about 1,000, most of them are part-time residents. Now, once a person said to me on my another video I did in Munds Park that, you know, there's not a lot of jobs here, and that's true, because again, it says mostly part-time residents here, and if you do have a job here, it's probably going to be for the golf course or one of the restaurants. Now, I do occasionally show homes here in Munds Park for people who want to live here and commute to Flagstaff to work, and that's actually not a bad plan. Homes are a little bit less than you'd find in Flagstaff, and it's only a 15-minute drive. So stay tuned, and I'm going to give you a great tour of Munds Park. My name is Dawn Dickenson. The channel is Living in Northern Arizona. This is where I will teach you everything there is to know about living in the north part of the state, what it's like to live here, eat here, sleep, work, and play here, everything you might want to know if you're thinking of moving here. If you like the video, please do me a favor and hit the like button, the subscribe button, and the notification bell, because that helps other people who are looking for this type of information find the video and find my channel. I sell real estate in the northern half of the state. I live in beautiful Sedona, Arizona, but I work in Sedona, Verde Valley, Flagstaff, Prescott. So if you have a question about real estate or you're thinking of buying something here, do what many people have done before and just give me a call, a text, an email, or go to my website and go in the description below to a link, and that will let you set up a Zoom call or a phone call on my calendar, and this way we won't miss each other. I would love to talk to you, and stay tuned to hear about Munds Park. Okay, right now I'm in the Fox Ranch portion of Munds Park. Now, this little area is actually about 10 miles before the main Munds Park exit, and it's a little bit isolated. I am on the east side of the freeway. I'm going to take you on the west side where most of the big clubhouse and most of the big homes are, but I wanted you to see this little area on the east because there is a home in here right now that's for sale, about $1.8 million, but it's on 12 acres. It's got a big house and there's some outbuildings to it. So if you want to be really isolated, this might be an area you're interested in, Fox Ranch. But now right here, it is a little bit close to the highway. You can hear the highway, but if you keep continuing down this road that I'm on, you can get away from that. But I'm going to take you now to the other side of Fox Ranch where there is a little more peace, and there's the clubhouse, and homes there are big and they go for over $1 million. So right now I'm standing outside of the gate that lets you into the gated community section of Foxborough Ranch. Now, in the past, I've always been able to get through the gate, but they've been expecting me. And today I realize I don't have any kind of a code to get in, but I want you to see back here. It's beautiful. They have a huge clubhouse. This is like the exclusive part of Munds Park. And actually, if you're headed north on the 17, the Fox Ranch exit is about 10 miles before the main Munds Park exit, but this still has a Munds Park address. Now, the homes back in here in Foxborough, they're all big, beautiful homes. Some of them are on acre. A lot of them are custom built. You probably couldn't find anything in here less than $1 million, but you might find something in the low 1.2 million. There might be something in the 800 range, but again, these are the pricey upscale Munds Park homes. And again, Foxborough Ranch is about 10 minutes before you get to the main part of Munds Park. So right now I am standing outside of AG's Barbecue Restaurant. So this is a restaurant in Munds Park. It's actually one of my favorite barbecue places, and I'm not a huge barbecue fan, but they got great ribs. They've got sides that have like this mac and cheese and potatoes to die for. Of course, not on my diet, but you know, it's a fun place to go. What else is neat about this place is during the summertime, and you know, we've got a little monsoon right now, so it's not very busy, but these tables back here, people can bring their dogs. So you can go inside, get your barbecue plate, and come sit out and just enjoy the meal with your family. Your little poochie can be on a leash and sit there and beg while you're trying to eat. It's a real fun place. So AG's my favorite Munds Park restaurant. So right now I'm standing outside of the Munds Park RV Park. Now there's a couple things to know about this place. First of all, it's seasonal. So if you have one of these park models right here, you can only come in the summer season, which is about April through October. And then here you would own the, usually these are park models, you would own the park model and then you would pay a lot fee. Now they're, depending on the section, they rent the lot out by the season. So it's anywhere from maybe $3,200 to close to $4,000 for the season, and then you're able to park your park model in this RV park. Or there are some places in the earlier phases where you could put your motorhome or your travel trailer or a fifth wheel and park it for the season as well. Now I can't tell you the rates for sure. Last time I looked them up was spring, went from $3,200 to $3,900 for the season. But this is a nice option if you don't want to buy a property in Munds Park. Now, of course, the spot I'm standing is very close to the freeway. If you go back there a little ways, you won't have as much freeway noise, but I'm right at the entrance, so it's a little bit loud right now. So this is what you see as you first turn into Munds Park. There'll be a lot of traffic coming in here because this is the main entrance. Right now we are having the start of the summer monsoon, and there's a bit of thunder and lightning going on behind me, so I'm not going to be here too long. Behind me is the Pinewood Cafe. Like, it's a locals restaurant where you can just get some of the basic food. And of course you got the gas station, then the real estate office, and Interstate 17 is right where you were looking just a moment ago. And hopefully nobody will get hit by lightning today, because I just heard a really, really loud clasp of thunder, which is always a little bit scary, but it's summer, so we get those monsoons, and that's what's happening right now. So right now I'm standing outside one of the main attractions of Munds Park, and it is Pinewood Country Club and Golf Course. Now, this one shows up as a semi-private golf course, and since I'm not a golfer, I can't tell you what it means, but it's a beautiful golf course here. And the nice thing about having a golf course here in the high country, you know, we're at almost 7,000 foot elevation, is in the summertime, it's a beautiful time to play golf. If you're from Phoenix, you know it's too hot to play golf in the summertime, and that's when people usually like to golf. So here in Munds Park, you're right near a golf course, a beautiful golf course, and it's a great place to come in the summertime. Now, if you're looking for a vacation home in the Pines, but you're not going to be here all the time, and you won't have to deal with a lot of maintenance, like, you know, raking up the pine needles, behind me is a beautiful condominium complex. Now, I have been inside of this complex, and it's beautiful. The homes are amazing. Right now, for example, there's one in here for sale. I think it's $335,000. The HOA fee is not that bad. It's in the low $200 a month, maybe $240, which, you know, in northern Arizona, that's not a bad thing at all. So you could come up in the summer and the wintertime, just come on in, leave your stuff inside, and not have to worry about maintaining it and pulling the weeds and all that stuff when you're gone. So this townhouse condominium complex could be a good option here for you in Munds Park, and it is right looking at the golf course, and there's some beautiful views. And like I say, I've been inside, and inside of the units is just beautiful. Now I'm on the south side of Pinewood Boulevard in the middle of Munds Park. I wanted to take you into this neighborhood because there are some homes here on much bigger lots. This is kind of the custom side where you have homes on half acre, quarter acre. You don't see that as much on the north side of Pinewood Boulevard, but if you want some big custom home and you want a little bit of space around you, this might be a good place to look. There are beautiful homes in here, and there's several for sale right now. So right now I'm in the section of Munds Park that allows you to put a manufactured home or a mobile home on your own piece of land. And there are a few advantages to this. One, of course, is it's a way that you could buy a second home or a vacation vacation property without investing a huge amount of money. Second is, like, behind me, there's a fence that leads you to the National Forest. So it's not that far from the National Forest, and you could be living in this beautiful community. Now, let me tell you another thing is, if you want to live in Munds Park, but you don't want to be near the manufactured homes, this is kind of an isolated road that they're all out. So they're kind of all aggregated together. So if you don't want to be near the mobile homes, you don't have to be. You can be further away from them. So another advantage, or another thing to know, I should say, is the double-wide mobile homes, manufactured homes that were built after 1976 and they're on their own land, you can actually get a conventional mortgage on these. Now, the question comes is, if you have anything built prior to June 15th, 1976, that's the date where HUD came in and made all the building standards for the manufacturing home industry. So that's the date you want to look for. Again, the mobile homes that are double wides, manufactured homes, I should say, because prior to 76, they call them mobile homes. The double wides and the ones on their own land can qualify for a traditional conventional mortgage. But that doesn't mean if you have an older one, you can't get a loan. I have three or four lenders that do lend on anything, you know, 1963 single wide, even park. But the caveat is, of course, they're going to charge you a much higher interest rate, probably 2 to 3 percentage points more than if you get a regular convention alone on one of the newer double wides on land. Now, here in Munds Park, let me tell you what they're going for. You can buy an older one, like a 60s model, for maybe in the $250,000 range. A lot of the newer ones, the ones that I'm driving past that you could see, are beautiful with the porches. Those are going to be in the $400,000 to $500,000 range. Again, beautiful homes. Look inside, you can't even tell the difference, but that's what they're going for right now here in Munds Park. So right now I'm on a road where there are a lot of the traditional site-built single-family cabin type homes. You'll see a lot of the streets here that are named after animals: grizzly, caribou, reindeer, Trout Creek. So that's kind of fun. A lot of these homes here, there's, again, many different sizes. Probably the smallest single family site built cabin you'll find might be, you know, 1,000 square foot, 12 square foot, two bed, two bath. Of course, they're going up to any price. There you could find something in the high 400s. The nicer three bed, two bath, 1,800 square foot home, say, on a quarter acre, that could be in the 650 to 850 range. But there are all types and sizes in here. I just wanted to give you an idea of what they are costing right now in 2022. Of course, right now the market is very high. You might be wondering, like, what kind of things are there to do in Munds Park, especially if you're not into golf. A lot of people like to buy or rent these side-by-sides. There are places that rent those, or a lot of the residents have their own, so they can just kind of drive around through the neighborhood or through the woods. There's also, of course, the golf course. There's shopping, and you can get to Flagstaff in 15 minutes. And of course, in the winter, there are a lot of the snow activities. Also, you know, the best thing though is just to kind of hang out with your family, sit around the campfire, toasting marshmallows, and enjoy the beautiful smell of the clean air. Again, we're at about 7,000 foot elevation, and so it doesn't get very hot. It's a great escape from the heat if you live in Phoenix, and just a beautiful place to live or buy a vacation home. Okay, so you see this road behind me. What I've done is I've come in on Pinewood Boulevard and I've come all the way to the end, and it suddenly turns into a dirt road. Now, if you'd keep going off this dirt road, you eventually go over Mormon Mountain, and off on the other side would be the Mormon Lake. Now, when I had my home in Mormon Lake, I used to cut through this place all the time. A little bit of a shortcut would keep me from going all the way to Flagstaff and back if I was going home to Sedona. But what I do want you to know, it's a very primitive road. I would not do that trip without four-wheel drive, and even with the four-wheel drive you may be beating up your vehicle, so you may want to just go ahead and go all the way to Flagstaff and back down if you're going to Mormon Lake, you know, back down on Forest Highway 3, Lake Mary Road. Or same thing, if you're going Mormon Lake and you want to get to Sedona, you might want to just go through Flagstaff. The other choice, of course, is to take Stoneman Lake Road, which is another primitive beat your car up road, but hey, if you've got four-wheel drive, you might want to do that. Okay, so right behind me, you will see the Pinewood Restaurant Bar. That's what I was just trying to tell you about. And then there's also a mini mart for people that, you know, are living here, staying here for the weekend. They just run in to get milk or something small. It's not a huge market, but there's a lot of things you can get here. And I'm about to leave Munds Park. I hope you enjoyed the video tour today. Right now, it's just getting a little bit dark. The sky, I heard some very loud lightning. Hopefully that guy won't be hitting me right now. And again, if you are interested in learning more about Munds Park, or if you have a real estate question, don't hesitate to give me a call or a text or an email, and I will get back to you. Again, Dawn Dickenson, Realty One Group Mountain Desert. Hope to see you back on my channel, Living in Northern Arizona. Hope to see you back here again next week.